Lawson from CreativeGuitarStudio.com. So if you've heard that it's important to learn all the notes on the guitar and you've decided that this is something that you want to do, then this video will be excellent for you. In it, we're going to look closely at a variety of simple ways to help you learn the notes on the neck and, even more important, help you understand what the best thing you can do is when it comes to learning the notes on guitar. Plus, along with that, we're going to break down the best way that this idea should be practiced. Afterward, I hope you'll join me on Patreon for the second half of this lesson. You're going to get to watch a bonus video there where I'm going to take the note learning ideas and the techniques covered here in this YouTube lesson and apply them in a real world situation by using all this within a melody line. We'll organize the melody in a couple of different ways so you'll understand how to learn notes for every melody or chord progression that you play. Now, let's begin with a note flow idea that demonstrates an easy way for how notes sit and how they move around on the guitar. Before we get started, I just want to let you in on how you can get yourself a copy of the Creative Guitar Studio Handouts Collection ebook. It's easy to do with any donation of $5 or more made on the creativeguitarstudio.com website. You'll instantly receive a copy of this 100-page guitar lesson ebook. It's jam-packed full of chords, scales, arpeggios, music theory, and technique drills. Join the thousands of guitar players who've already received their copy of this amazing lesson book. Just head to creativeguitarstudio.com/donations. To donate and download your copy today. For most students of guitar, you know, the first thing that they think they need to know is the note names on the neck, which is good. There's nothing wrong with that. However, once, you know, a student will typically start learning, you know, the common thing that happens is they get into playing shapes and they play songs and other stuff, you know, and it's more by way of how the shape or the patterns will look rather than knowing actual notes. And this is a real detriment sometimes because, you know, you can go on for years and not really understand the notes on the guitar. And I mean years. I mean, I've met some students where it's been like 3, 4, 5 years and they really don't understand the notes at all. So to help get those notes, you know, we're going to start the lesson here with an easy note exercise that does two great things. It helps with note location and it helps you learn how to target one note to establish its place on guitar. So what we're going to do is we're going to check out some notes here off the open third string. We're going to look at it coming at it from the G into an A. And then we'll go B, C, D on the second string, and then we'll have E, F, G up to a high A on that first string. So all I want you to do is just go through those notes and call them out loud. G, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, A. You can even go backwards if you want. A, G, F, E, D, C, B, A, G. Very simple, but it is going to start getting you acquainted with those note names. Now, here's the really interesting thing. We're going to do what's called a note flow. We're going to take those notes from that open position layout, and we're going to move them over here to the G being now located right there on the fourth string, fifth fret. It's the same G from the open third string. In fact, you know, one of the first things you learn about on guitar is how to tune it. So you would tune it from that G on the fifth fret of the fourth string to an open third string G, and then you'd be able to tune your guitar string on the third string to that lower note that hopefully is in tune already. You'd obviously start from the sixth string going across to do those methods, but I'm not going to talk about tuning right now. I want to get into flowing those notes from that open position group we just did over here from this G that's located on the fifth fret of the fourth string. So now what we're going to have is this G moving over to the third string, A, B, and C, and then jumping to the second string, D, E, and F, and then we'll have G and A again, but it's just going to be basically in the same spots as it was before from our open group layout. So now, those are the exact same notes that we had started with from the open position, but they're, you know, flowing in a different way, in a new position on the neck. Call them out as you work on this, G, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, A. And you can go in reverse as well. Now, let me show you how this can keep flowing, because remember, this is a note flow that we're working on here. So now we're going to take all those notes from that position we were just working on, and we're going to flow them over here in the middle of the neck now. So the root for us for the G is going to be over here on the 10th fret of the 5th string, and we're just going to use all those same notes, G, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, A. you know, just all the same tones. Make sure you call them out loud as you play through. We are playing the notes of the key of C here. It's really simple, but we're just kind of focusing on a lowest tone of G just to kind of, you know, have ourselves squared away with one pitch there. That's kind of our focal tone. And we're going through all those notes. G, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, A. All right, so that's that layout. We're gonna flow all of those notes now really high. We're gonna go between 12th and 15th frets. And the low G now, that one that we're having, is going to be based on the sixth string at the 15th fret. But it's the same group of tones that we were just working on over here, but now it's located in the 12th position. So now we have G, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, and A. You can tell what we're doing. We're really mapping a lot of this stuff out in about a four string chunk of notes to be able to get everything. And we've just kind of flowed all those same notes in across the guitar fingerboard into different locations. And the awareness factor is going to come from actually calling them out loud. And that's why I think it's so important. Make sure you do that as much as possible. Could take you a while before everything feels comfortable. But remember, we are just dealing with the alphabet here, starting on that G. G, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, A. Again, G, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, A. And then again, G, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, A. From the open string, G, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, A. And, you know, that's all it really is to get you acquainted with flowing a simple group of notes, and there's not very many there, we're just flowing them along the neck through across to different positions, and they're all the same group. We're not going into any higher or lower octave registers or anything like that. We're using a principle that's referred to as unisons to do this. It's absolutely excellent work, and it really gets you acquainted with how things move around and flow on the fingerboard. Now, when we jump into the next exercise, I'm going to get you to set up something more specific into a scale for a key signature and all that. That's going to be what's coming up next. And then when we join together again on Patreon, I'm going to take this into a really fun direction because we're going to jump into melody work. I'll have a melodic statement. We'll do it in one region, and then we'll take that statement over to a new region, and I'll teach you how these things can flow along the neck. Plus, I'll have a new strategy for you in thinking about note naming, because that is a huge aspect, as well as calling the notes out loud as you work on this stuff. So we'll take a short break and we'll get into our next topic, which is actually getting toward a key signature. Once the notes have been put through their relocation process, the next stage involves isolating one note and then using that note to create a scale that targets both the key signature and the tonality. For us, we're going to focus on the key of C, and in that key, we'll use the note of A to build the tonality of minor scales. The next phase of work I have for you gets into doing what's referred to as cross position scales. And I have a setup of a scale for A minor here for us, but it's just going to be using all the notes that we have been studying so far. So first thing I want to do is just play this scale pattern down for you. It goes like this. The main thing to understand is that we are targeting an A note. Our focal point here for the tonality and the key and everything is for A minor coming from the key of C. So let me play that one more time. You can tell there it's starting on the A note on the second fret of third string. You notice that slide that we did to do the cross position. We were starting an open position and then we moved it up into the third fret area. Let me play that for you one more time before we move on. It goes like this. So you'll want to learn that, but most important, you're going to want to call those notes out. So we have A, G, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, A, G, F, E, D, C, B, A, G, A. That's a really important fundamental here, is you want to call those notes out and understand where the positions are at for your changes and how everything sets itself up on the fingerboard. So that's a really simple one. I have a new one here I want to move into you next. It's going to be starting off a seventh fret on the fourth string G, and A is going to be down on that G fret on the 10th fret on the fifth string. So we're starting on the seventh fret A on the fourth string, and this pattern goes like so. You notice how we did that transition on that second string from 8 to 10, sliding just like that, get us into our new fretboard area. Again, you'll want to call out those notes, A, G, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, A, G, then F, E, D, C, B, A, G, A. So understand that we have a string, we have a fret, you know, we have the note name for the particular fret, and you want to help all of that get really well resolved in your mind so that you don't think about it too much. And the best way to do that is to set the positions up, understand how you're moving around them, and then call out the notes as you go. Now, I do have one more idea that I want to work through with you, and it's going to get us into something a little bit different. It's called double whole step work. Sometimes people call it three notes per string scales, but we're going to start that off on the A at the 12th fret here on the 5th string. We'll have 12th, 14th, and 15th catching our first group of notes. Let me play it for you first, and then we'll go through the details. You can tell on the descending run of notes, I had those three, the double whole steps, I should say, the three note per string ideas coming along. Let's just go through that again. It's a little bit easier to do up here, and that's why I decided to show it to you guys up here, because we have the smaller fret spacing on the fingerboard, so it's easier to do those reaches. And you can tell how I'm doing the setup of them is index, middle, and small finger, okay? Now, let's go through those note names and get that squared away. So we've got A, B, C, D, E, F, G, A, G, F, and then E, D, C, B, A, G, A, B, A. All right, so call out those note names. Get good at that double whole step reach that you have with index to middle to small finger. It's kind of a little bit different assignment on that one. But, you know, if you put some time into it, it's going to start to feel fairly comfortable. As you move around the neck and do other keys, though, it's going to get, you know, harder in other positions, because as you move down the fingerboard, those double whole step reaches are going to get pretty challenging for you. But otherwise, this is kind of that next level of work. You pick a key that you're going to work in. You get solid on a note that you want to have as a focal tone, and you can make the major tone that, you know, idea. We're in the key of C, so if you just, you know, focused on a C note and you went ascending and descending through patterns like that, I mean, you'd have C major scale. But here we decided to go up to the relative minor tonality, so we took the A. The A is the sixth note of the C major scale, and the sixth note of any major scale gives you that relative minor tonality. The modal name for it is called Aeolian mode, or, you know, the common name for it is natural minor scale. So lots of stuff to do here. Really great work for getting these note names together. Really, guys, the trick to this is get those note names being called out loud. That's what's really going to solidify this in your mind. So what we're going to do next is wrap things up here on YouTube. We're going to catch up next in the Patreon, where I got some melody work for you. It's going to be very similar. I got some nice melody work with some backing chord progressions. You'll get a jam track with your Patreon download, and you'll be able to work out a melody in a couple different areas of the neck. We're going to kind of give you some more tips on moving into better recall of the notes and so forth. I hope to see you next in the Patreon lesson. If you're signed up as one of my $15 a month Patreon members, you'll get to watch a bonus video where I'm going to take the note learning ideas and the techniques that we've covered here in the YouTube lesson and apply them in a real world situation by having all this stuff work within a melody line that will get reorganized in a different way so that you can learn notes and every melody and chord progression that you ever come across. Plus, as a Patreon member, along with that bonus video, you're going to get a jam track, and you'll also get to download a detailed PDF handout that allows you to understand how all the examples work in both music notation and in tab. Plus, it also includes a number of additional tips and explanations that you don't get in the video lessons. So head over to my Patreon, become a $15 a month supporter today at patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio. And guys, if you want to help support the channel even further, check out our Teespring store. The link is located inside the top pinned comment below. The store has all kinds of great guitar designs on t-shirts, sweaters, bags, hats, and coffee cups. All the designs and the prints are top quality. In fact, I'm wearing one of the shirts right now. Let me tell you, the fabrics and the prints are just fantastic. Go and check out the store, and if you're a member of the website, use your Creative Guitar Studio coupon code to get your members discount at checkout on Teespring. Now, if you found this video helpful, make sure you leave your comments and give the video a thumbs up below. And remember, if you're looking for a step-by-step guitar program that puts real tested methods into a proven guitar course, not just random YouTube videos, it's all available over at creativeguitarstudio.com. Plus, you're going to want to make sure you're seeing all my guitar lessons here on YouTube. So go and turn on those notifications, ring the bell, and subscribe to the channel. All right, guys, I'll be back here again real soon with another video. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you again next time. Bye for now. I've got 25 years experience teaching guitar and have written a well-organized step-by-step guitar course. Head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up for a free membership today. Join the thousands of members worldwide who have already enrolled. There's no need to try learning the guitar on your own. Let me help you become the best guitar player that you can be.